Hello everyone, it's Jess Hearts. First up, I just want you to do a little something. Go look up Hawaiian Roller Coaster Ride and play it just quietly in the background just so you can hear it as you watch this. So you get in the mood I was in when building this, which was like complete and utter nostalgic bliss and tropical vibes. Yes, today we are building Lilo and Nani's house from Lilo and Stitch. Now this version is kind of a conglomeration of the house before and after it gets destroyed. Also, we'll be talking about some parts of the movie which will probably spoil it if you haven't seen it. Considering it's been out for 17 years and, you know, you should have dang watched this beauty by now. So yeah, spoilers alert. Don't worry, I'm not just being rude to those who haven't watched it. Or if you're a little younger and this movie wasn't really on the air for you, my boyfriend hasn't seen it either, so I'm going to be spoiling it for him too. Soz babe, we'll watch it this weekend. But to start off with, I just want to say how friggin' cute is Stitch? Like, I've seen him so many times this week. It's just, how adorable is he? To give you an idea of how much this movie meant to my, like, a generation, I guess, an old best friend of mine literally has tattoos of him going up her arm. And I don't care if you think that's weird or tacky, he is adorable and deserves all the love he can get. And, you know, even one of those tattoos is the one of him with a bikini top on his head. So yeah, absolutely precious. I also want to say thank you guys so, so much for the love that my base game beach house got. I wasn't expecting that. We gotta look out for our base game buddies, you know? I'd love to do a base game version of this house, but that would probably be a lot of work, and honestly, I ain't ready for that. I said on Twitter that this is probably, in my opinion, the best build I've ever done. I've certainly done more intense and, I guess, grand builds, but the movies in the series just mean so much. So yeah, I got that bias under my belt. Like, my parents can barely remember my name, let alone birthday, yet they remember how much I love this movie. So yeah, bit sad, but you know, it's okay because Stitch. I also put in some photos of all the research I did for this build, because a heap of people on Twitter were like, how did you build this in 3.5 hours? And yes, I genuinely did. My boyfriend and I counted up the recording time. Well, he did. I'm bad at math. But on the night that Island Living was being released, I stayed up to like 1 a.m.-ish, and Australia and New Zealand got it first. So that was nice. But from early on in the day, after I released my last speed build, I was watching snippets from the movie and looking up heaps of videos and photos and sketched out the layout of the house. And, you know, it was so, so fun, but kind of intense. Since I had been like awake since hella early, but man, I was just so excited to build this. I haven't been this keen in ages for a build, so it got released and I found the lot I was gonna build on. I nearly built this, but instead I promptly fell to the right and fell asleep. Then I built it the next day. I always try to get photos of like every inch of these movie TV show builds so I can make them as canon and accurate as possible, because that's how much I love you guys. I don't know when it's a build and you're like super happy or passionate about it. It kind of just builds itself. I'm also glad that Solani has some hills and uneven terrain, because it kind of makes us look less weird, being as though the house is kind of up against a hill. I even included the little hammock area where Lilo and Nani sit. Of course, we don't have hammocks in The Sims 4, and this pack would have been the best opportunity to do it, but I still included a little seat. Oh man, though, that scene is so, so sad and sweet, though. I put a little toy ducky on Stitch's bed to represent the Ugly Duckling book he reads and has kind of an epiphany from. I included a book with a little orange fish on it for Lilo next to her bed as a nod to her buddy Pudge the Fish, whom she feeds peanut butter sandwiches to every Thursday, and you know why? It's because she thinks Pudge controls the weather. So yeah, you could say Lilo is very serious when it comes to respecting the gods. Also, Nani, her older sister, tries to put tuna in the sandwich for Pudge without really thinking. Thank heck Lilo caught this, because Pudge would have hecked her up for that blunder. If you don't get why this is a bad move, I really implore you to go to an aquarium ASAP. Pretty much Lilo is lonely and doesn't quite fit in, can relate. She has a little homemade toy named Scrump, who I think is just friggin' adorable. I also added a stuffed creature that is meant to represent Scrump on her bed. Kind of a jump, but you know, they're the same color, so it's canon. But yeah, she was bullied by a little redheaded girl named Myrtle, and I won't even touch that because there's already a really cool video by Whatso Videos who analyzes why she bullies Lilo, and it's really kind of sad. But she even taunts her about Lilo's deceased mum, and, you know, that's just not cricket, mate. So, yeah, Lilo is quite lonely and prays for an angel to be a friend. Enter stage left, Stitch, an alien life form created by evil genius Dr. Jumba Jukipa, I'm sorry, who is honestly a fave character of mine. I think he is hilarious. Pretty much Stitch escaped from space prison where he and Jumba were being imprisoned for obvious reasons, and he landed in Hawaii, only to be presumed as some weird looking doggo, and is taken to the pound, and guess who picks him up? Nani and Lilo. As a child, I didn't really think a lot about Nani, I won't lie, but now I am 21 and I am capable of empathy, I can really see how awesome Nani is. Like, what a good role model she is for younger people. If you look at the dresser in Nani's bedroom in the movie, and just all over her room, you can see heaps of surfing awards, medallions, and just surfing memorabilia. But Lilo and Nani's parents died in a car crash during a storm, which is why I think Lilo gives Pudge the sandwich every Thursday, so, you know, the same thing doesn't happen again. So Nani had to step in as the kind of parental role in the household, and I guess from that, from what I can see, she gave up her surfing career at the same time. She puts Lilo first, almost to a fault. She works part-time as a waitress and even has some kind of a romance with an entertainer named David. But because Nani is so overwhelmed with taking care of Lilo and making sure she doesn't get taken away by a social worker, that everything else gets put on the back burner. So yeah, kind of a sad story, but Nani is just an awesome person and definitely one of my favorite characters. Yeah, and she puts family first, and as we know, Ohana means family, and family means nobody gets left behind. And the social worker that we meet is Mr. Cobra Bubbles, who honestly is such a super cool character who ends up being like kind of a family friend in the end. And if you watch the series, you'll know that Bubbles isn't really who he says he is. Well, he is a social worker, but he did work for the CIA and knows the grand councilwoman for the alien embassy, which just puts this movie on a whole new level of cool. And I suggest you go read up on him. He is honestly so interesting. There is actually so much going on with behind the obvious story of Lilo and Stitch. I think that's another thing that makes it so great. They made a full-blown narrative where characters aren't as shallow as Solani's waters. Woohoo! And that's gonna lead me to my review opinion of Island Living part of the video. If you want aesthetics, beautiful build and buy objects, and amazing Kaz items, buy it. That's pretty much why I did, because it looks amazing. I had a lot of hope that this pack would bring me back to playing The Sims 4, and it has, but I also just bought Island Paradise for The Sims 3. Yes, it runs on my computer, but even Delicracy is disappointed with a lot of, you know, stuff that happened there. And I think a lot of the time The Sims 4 likes to set dress. We didn't have a lot of amazing objects and Kaz in The Sims 3, but we did have a huge world, or we did have huge worlds, just so much gameplay, and there was depth, mind the pun. But The Sims in The Sims 3 had so many more traits, like EA created Sims with storylines that actually matched up with the traits and friendships and skills. With The Sims 4, that simply isn't always the case. Apparently it's on an alternate universe, but sometimes I just see that as a cop-out. Don't get me wrong, I adore The Sims 4, but I would be lying if I said it gave me the same warm, comfy, happy feeling previous games in the franchise have given me. Yes, I know we shouldn't compare, they are totally different games, but like, who doesn't? Come on, there's nothing wrong with that either. That's how we grow and produce better games, movies, books, and everything. We have to compare and contrast. Obviously, the Island Paradise pack ran crappy and had a lot of bugs and lagged, but we had so much more to do. You know what I did the other day as my Sim self? I walked down to the other side of town without loading screens by the beach and just sat there and skipped stones. It was awesome. I think that's a good example of the tiny details that were put into the game to make it a simulation of life, and that's essentially what it is. Our Sims don't even cuddle in bed in The Sims 4 without a mod. I'm sorry for complaining, but I love The Sims franchise so much that I just want to see it thrive. And this pack is honestly a little bit of a letdown gameplay-wise. My mates don't have a skill tree, which I understand, vampires got their own pack and yada yada yada, but they should have still implemented it, you know? There's no hotels, resorts, can't even dive underwater without it being a rabbit hole. It's just, we got dolphins though. Okay, I'm sorry. I do love this pack, but I stand with Deli and so many others when we say this pack is just lacking. It honestly just feels kind of like a larger game pack. I'm hoping we, like, in the next packs it gets better. I hope Realm of Magic is going to get better anyway. Like, I'm not even going to touch the Moschino pack. I won't even go there. I love the new careers in Island Living, though, I won't lie. The off-the-grid house trait needs some work, but the premise is very good. But overall, I think they miss the mark a bit. So yeah, that's my teeny, brutal, honest review of the pack. Sorry if you came here to hear me talk about Lilo and Stitch. I went on a bit of a tangent there, but, you know. But yes, we'll go back to Lilo and Stitch. Stitch is essentially an overly aggressive little blue dude who learns to love. He is being chased by Jumba and Pleakley, who is a master of disguise, who have been set with the task to capture him by the alien embassy. But they all end up living together and becoming a family, which is honestly so beautiful. I totally just remembered. It's also Captain Gantu, and he's a stupid head. He works for the embassy too, and he ends up like trying to capture everyone, but then he loses his job, I think, and ends up working for some like intergalactic hamster rabbit hybrid trying to capture the other creations Jumba made. Whew. Or as they call them in Hawaii, cousins. So in the TV series, we see Lilo and Stitch trying to capture his cousins and rehome them to the people of Hawaii before Gantu and Hamsterville get to them and try to capture them as well. I think one of the cousins I remember fondly is the one who makes sandwiches all the time, because I can relate to that a lot. I also ended up making Nani and Lilo and Kaz for the house, and they're up on the gallery. I won't lie, I did have fun playing as them for a little bit. But I do need a Stitch, so if anyone's up to the challenge for making a Stitch, put them up in the gallery and tag me. Hashtag JessHartStitch. Oh yeah, also, I have a build challenge again. It's under hashtag JessHartsBuildChallenge3 in the gallery. Oh, my voice just died there. Whoops. And it has to be in by the 10th of July. You cannot add any full walls to the exterior of the build, but you can change the foundation colours and the stairs. Fences are allowed, more foundations, decking, and all that fun stuff too, but I'll be randomly selecting a few and touring them in a video, so get building. Base game houses deserve some love too. Oh yeah, I hope you guys noticed I built the tiny San Francisco that Stitch built in Lilo's room. That was honestly so much fun to build, and it's just so cute. And I also built Stitch's bed. I am really proud of this build, and I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I hope you guys go download it and play as Nani and Lilo. But yeah, remember to subscribe, like and comment, tick that bell, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye. Also, as a thing, I love Elvis. I love the king.